Why are your disciples not fasting? Why are they walking through this field and eating while we fast? And Jesus turns to them and he says, how can the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is still with them? One day, I assure you, the bridegroom will be taken from them. And in that day, they will mourn for me. In that day, they will fast for me. That is why they are not fasting right now. One day, I will be taken from you. And in that day, you will fast. And in that day, you will mourn for me. I'm not giving you the Great Commission because you have nothing else better to do. I'm giving you the Great Commission as an invitation to that wedding day. I'm giving you the Great Commission to invite me back. I'm giving you the Great Commission so that you will mourn for me, so that you will fast for my great return. The Great Commission was never busy work. It was an invitation to my next coming.
Yes.
It was an invitation to me coming back. It was never busy work. And this promise of Matthew 24, this gospel will go to every tribe, tongue, and people. With Matthew 28, there will be a day when someone puts on a heavy backpack and they trek up into an unknown village with hundreds of little tiny huts with thatched roofs and snow on the ground, and they will walk up to a hut and they will knock on a door and it will open to them, and it'll be some girl who never thought she would ever do anything magnificent for God. And she'll whisper these words to this person that opens the door. And they'll say, do you know what God did in my life? Do you know about the man Jesus Christ? Do you know that he can save to the uttermost? Did you know that he is the one true living God? Did you know? And he will scream out with a boom, that was the last person to hear the gospel. I am back. What would it be like for a generation to say, I want to be like that person. I want to be the one with the heavy backpack. I want to be the one trekking through the snow. I want to be the one that goes to the deepest jungle. I want to be the one that stays in a Bedouin tent. I want to be the one in the hillside yurt. I want to be the one in the boat on my way to a Polynesian island. I want to be the one to share the gospel with the very last. The Great Commission was never about doing. The Great Commission was always about finishing. It was always about that last person. Return to us. Return to us. We're mourning for you. That is wild in their generation. We need the people who will eat the dirty food, who will sleep in the dirty house, who will go to the most difficult, who will go to the hardest, who will go to the darkest place. We need the wild ones to rise up in this hour. The people who do not love their lives, even unto death. Oh, it's irresistible to him. He will put your spirit. Oh, it is irresistible to him. He's going to put his spirit in you. He's going to anoint you.
Come on.
He's going to put his hand on you.
It's you.
It's irresistible to him. He needs the person who will sell everything and buy a field that looks empty. Everyone around you will tell you that is an empty field. Why are you selling everything? Oh, you're so smart. You have so much purpose. Oh, you could do so much. Oh, why? Don't do that. Don't do that. God's looking for that. He's looking for the man, for the woman who will sell everything and buy an empty field. But you know what is out there. Oh, you know that there's treasure out there. You know that there's treasure hidden. That's why you're able to sell everything with confidence. Oh, you're a treasure, Jesus. Missions is not your good gift to God. Missions is God's good gift to you. You're gonna find him in the field. He's the Lord of the harvest. So he's in the harvest. Go find him. Everyone around you will tell you, no, 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 no. This generation, I believe, will be the generation of yes. Yes, I will sell. Yes, I will go. That field to me, it's not empty. It's full of everything that I've ever wanted. It's full of God. It's full of God. I must have it. Forsake what seemed normal. I forsake it for your inspiration we need.
I say yes, absolutely yes. I say yes, absolutely yes. I say yes, absolutely.
Ask yourself this question: why do I live here and they have to live there, where they cannot hear about the gospel, where there's no church, where there's no Bible? Why do I get to live here and they have to live there? And once you start asking this question, it is over for you, because you'll realize that the reason you live here and they live there is because you are supposed to go there. You are supposed to learn a weird language there, and you are supposed to dress like you don't dress right now, and you are supposed to tell them. And without you going and telling them, there's no reason why you're living where you're living. You were meant to waste your life. You were meant to pour out your alabaster flask of expensive ointment. And I tell you, wherever the gospel is preached, the story of this woman, Mary of Bethany, will be told. You were meant to go there. That's why you were born here. You weren't meant to stay here. You were meant to go there.
Take the lead, oh,
Jesus turns to his disciples and he looks out at the crowds and he sees that they're harassed and that they're helpless. They're like sheep with no shepherd. And he turns to his best friends and he says, look, the harvest is truly plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray earnestly to the Lord of the harvest to send forth laborers into the harvest. The harvest is ripe in Afghanistan. It is ripe in North Korea. It is ripe in Mongolia. It's ripe in Indonesia. It's ripe in Iran. It's ripe in Saudi Arabia and in Somalia. It's ripe. But the laborers are few. Too many are hearing the call of God and waiting. But I tell you, in Matthew 28, God says to go everywhere, to every person, and baptize all of them, and to teach all of them everything. I'm telling you, you do not need an audible voice. You have a verse. You never needed an audible voice to go to the field. You have a verse. You have Matthew 28. Go everywhere. Go to everybody. Tell them the gospel. He's already told us all to go. He's already told us all to go. And this incredible promise follows in Matthew 28. If you do this great commission, I promise you, I will be with you even until the end of the age. Matthew 28, this great commission, it was always an invitation to a wedding day. His wedding day. And Father, we say right now, that's the voice we need to hear. And we say yes, absolutely yes, to the call of missions in Jesus' name.
Absolutely.